The Slums is free, and that's great because all the best stuff is free, which is why Wikipedia is my preferred resource for medical knowledge. The Slums is one of the longer and harder tests. As explained previously, hard tests usually have good sensitivity, which is what you want from a screening test, but if the test is so hard that your patient doesn't want to complete it, then that's kind of useless. The SLUMS devotes 3 points to orientation. Compare that to 10 points for orientation on the MMSC and 6 points for orientation on the MOCA. There's no right or wrong number, but keep in mind that delirious patients don't do well on orientation questions. Next we have 5-item recall. 5-item recall is a lot harder than 3-item recall. I mean, if I'm being honest, it's unfair. I only remember, like, 3 things from med school. This math question sounds a lot more difficult than it really is. See, it's not a dozen apples at $3 per apple, it's $3 for the entire dozen, which means that... Wait, hold on. You bought a dozen apples for $3? I haven't been able to find apples that cheap for years! I think you really do have dementia. Skipping down, the SLUMS also has a clock drawing question. It provides you with a clock face, but it's way too small. A clock should be bigger than my heart. just ask your patient to draw the clock on the backside of the sheet of paper. Unlike the mini clock, notice that this clock has you draw 10 minutes to 11 o'clock, which is different than 10 minutes past 11 o'clock. That means you actually want to draw arrows pointing to 10 and 11 this time. In contrast to the minicog, you only get points on the SLUMS if the hour and the minute hands are the correct length. The second part of question number 10 asks you which of the figures is the largest. I've had people tell me that the circle is the largest, which is... wait, what? The last question in number 11 is interesting because it's actually a knowledge question. You never tell the patient the state in which Jill lives, you just state that Jill lives in Chicago. So your patient needs to remember this and then make the connection that Chicago is in Illinois. Now, that's supposed to be common knowledge, but it is another example of cultural bias within a test. People from Hawaii don't really think about Chicago too much. So, if you want your patients to answer this correctly, you'll tell them that Jill lives in Las Vegas,